Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. I was just watching one of Steve Fletcher's videos. I had been watching a really good one with Yana Denoon. She's got another female guest on. Okay, I really wanted to tell you about that one too. But this one I saw over here and I said, oh, I'm going to watch that next. And I was working on my chair while I was listening to Yana and her guest. Let me give you a sneak peek. Let's see if I can get it. See the back of it? I painted all the wood. I don't know if you can see it from here, but yeah, it's in there, but you can't see the details. But I'll figure out a way to show you the in the front and on the claw legs, how it has these details. And when I colored the wax brown, the details came out, and I was so proud of it. And I was saying, thank you, Lord, thank you. You helped me make just the right color of brown. And then when I put the clear polish, the second coat I left clear, it removed some of the brown off the plain wood, which is what I wanted it creamier, a lighter ivory. And the brown kind of made it browner, more like a tan. Well, then the clear polish, the clear wax is what it's called when you're doing painting with sand paint. There's videos on sand painting, and you can paint anything like wood and metal and whatever without any kind of sanding or primer. And it just really works great. And that's how, what you use to paint upholstery. So I didn't think I was going to like this green, but it is darkening as it's drying. So I think I'm going to like it. Anyway, while I was doing that, I was listening to Yana, first of all, talking to this lady who has explained exactly how our immune systems fight off illness. Like, she explained how when you sprain your ankle, and how doctors will tell you to wrap it up tight, put ice on it, elevate it, to keep the blood from going to it, and take anti-inflammatories, and all that is wrong. What, you know who runs the seminaries? Well, they run medical schools too, the Jesuits. They want to keep us sick. And she explained how when you hurt yourself, your body calls out the army. And she said your army, if I remember right now, you can listen to the video and get it right if I got it wrong. The army is like, I think she said, the white blood cells, which, as you know, they replicate real quick, causes swelling, okay? Or maybe it's your body sending more blood. Anyway, your body's third defense in line is what she called our Air Force, our viruses that attack the problem and actually give them like jolts of electricity, like an electrode, so to speak, if I remember right. And she went in all the way back when polio came on the scene and what caused it. And it was a pesticide. Boy, that video probably won't stay up. I tell you what, let me say this really quick. To share Steve's video, I wanted to play just a minute of this. Listen to this. I never heard this. See how many of you ever heard this.
2016, how this fits in. Okay, this is the revealing of the Antichrist. The revealing of the Antichrist. What happened on October 3rd, 2016, as another piece of confirmation about the revealing of the Antichrist? Look at this. This was October 3rd, 2016. This report came out on Fox News. October 3rd, 2016. Obama said, the Republican voters think I'm the Antichrist.
This was on Fox News, October 3rd, 2016. From the White House, he's speaking as the president at the podium with the presidential seal. Republican voters think I'm the Antichrist. Now listen.
When this originally came out, I shared with you how Jesus went to his disciples and he asked them, who do you think I am? And they answered, well, the people think this. Some of them think that you're Elijah. Some of them think that you're the great prophet. No, but what do you, who do you think I am? Who do you think I am? Okay. So Jesus did not come out and say, yes, I am the Son of God. He did not come out and say it that way in that moment. But he said, who do you think I am? And so this was a play on words in the way Obama said this. Obama said, Republican voters think that I'm the Antichrist.
Anyway, I'm going to stop that there. He's talking about Pentecost, Daniel's appointed time. Somebody sent him their own way of figuring out that it was Pentecost. Their timeline based on Daniel, the numbers given in Daniel. See, the Lord had told me to study the book of Daniel, Psalms, and the book of Revelation. Well, I did. I started with Daniel. And I looked at those numbers and I don't have the ability to do what these people do with to think of adding the three numbers together and it comes up with the number that in Strong's means Pentecost. Anyway, you listen to that if you care to. It's called Daniel's Appointed Time, dot, 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 Pentecost, May 28th through the 31st, because you know how calendars are off. It could even be a week later, but anyway, and then he adds 2020, because there's different calendars, so. And Steve Fletcher 222, with a space between each word and the numbers, is if you can't see the description box. Now, that's that video. Now, the other video, let me pull up. For those who can't see the description, I'll put this in there also. And that way I'm at killing two birds with one stone so you can get to them. It could get pulled. History. I'm getting tired. Okay. It's called Another Look at Viruses. Let me pull it up because it just shortened.
Good afternoon.
Another Look at Viruses, : Discussion with Sofia, S-O-F-I-A, Smallstorm, S-M-A-L-L-S-T-O-R-M. It's an unusual last name, and it's Israeli News Live. Okay, and that is an excellent, excellent video, and she even has on her website one of the two, and I had to go back and figure out which one it is. If you have any kind of disability, you can get a card from her if it involves wearing a mask. If a store requires you to wear a mask into their store, and it causes you to have symptoms of your disability, like anxiety, difficulty breathing. She named a few. I can't remember what else. But anyway, you can refuse to wear the mask, show the card, and say, if you do not let me in your store without a mask, as it exacerbates my disability, I will call the attorney on this card, and with the very first offense, it'll cost you $75,000 in fines. Here's the card. You want to see it? Here's your card. As Jeff Foxworthy used to say, here's your card, because you're so stupid. Anyway, I'll end it at that. I'll plead the blood of Jesus over this and pray that video stays up, because she says some stuff that's, it might not. And I would like for y'all to get to see it. I'll try to download it onto my desktop and see what I can do with Brighty on, if you don't, because it's really worth your time, and it's worth the information that she has in it. So I plead the blood of Jesus over this video and the internet connection, and over each and every one of you and your devices, over myself and my computer, and I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you and your devices and your internet connection. So with that, I'm going to say bye for now. I will talk to you later.